In this video, we'll learn how to calculate percentage increase in Excel. Now I'm going to show you two different methods. Stick around to the end so that you'll get to see both of these methods. In case you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I post one video every week so that you can up your game in the field of data science. So let's get started. Now let's look at the setup. With me, I have product yearly sales quarter over quarter. Now, when I have the quarter over quarter sales information, obviously I want to know whether I have increased from quarter one to quarter two sales, quarter two to quarter three sales, quarter three to quarter four sales. That's how we're going to be. That's where we have the opportunity to basically calculate percentages increase or decrease within Excel. The formula that we're going to be using are going to be similar, but the method in which we write it will differ. And so let's look at both the methods. And later you can decide which one you're comfortable using. So first, let's look at the quarter one to quarter two increase or decrease, right? Now in quarter one, we made 17K sales, and in quarter two, we made 12K sales, which means that we have reduced from quarter one to quarter two sales, right? So now if you had to see the growth, obviously, it will mean that we're going to be showing a negative growth here. That is basically a decrease from quarter one to quarter two sales. Now, I have marked quarter one with A and quarter two with B so that it's easy to follow when I'm writing the formula, right? So let's look at how to get the difference between quarter two and quarter one first. To get the difference, I'm going to say B4 minus the A4, right? That is D4 minus C4 in the range formulas. Press enter and I'll get minus 5,000. Now, what percentage of minus 5,000 is of 17K here, right? That's the percentage that we need to calculate, and that will give us the percentage decrease from quarter one to quarter two. So if I had to write it, it will be this divided by the 17K and I get a minus 28% decrease. Now this formula, what we essentially did is we took the latest quarter and subtracted the quarter one value from the quarter two value. Then we divided the difference by quarter one's value to get the percentage increase or decrease. That's how you should be looking at this particular formula. Now if I had to write it completely without the supporting cell, it's going to be looking something like this. It's going to be quarter two minus quarter one, and I have to enclose this within the round bracket. That will give us the difference, and then I divide it by the quarter one to get the percentage increase or decrease. Now if you see the format like this, do not worry, it's basically the formatting, it's basically copying the formatting from these two cells to replicate it. You can simply change it to percentage and it will get back to that minus 28%. Now, if I copy these cells towards the right hand side, you'll see that it will show whether it has increased or decreased. Unfortunately, since from quarter three onwards, there has always been an increase, and that's why you're seeing positive numbers. So if I just copy the formula to the right hand side, you'll notice that we will see growth percentage. So from 12K to 26K, it's doubled. And so we are seeing 107%. That is, whatever value we have, it's over that and a little more than that, right? So that's why 107%. Similarly, from 26 to 39, it's going to be 13K increase, and it's nearly 50% of it. That is 13K or so. And that's why we are seeing a 51% increase. So this is the first method of how you calculate percentage increase or decrease within Excel. Now the second method is going to be even much more easier to type. So let's see how we can do that. In the second method, what we do is we take the first number, that quarter two number or the B number, and divide it by the A number and subtract one from it. Basically what we are saying is we are taking quarter two as a percentage of quarter one, and that will give us certain amount. And if we, and obviously it will be a little more than the whole, right? That whole, I say 100%, right? So what we do is we subtract one from it to basically get the right percentage growth So let's see how we can do that. So I'm going to say quarter two divide by quarter one, right? Now this is going to show me that difference of how much quarter two is a percentage of quarter one, and then I will subtract from this one to get you the percentage decrease or increase. So if I do this, I get the same 28% that we initially saw in the first formula. And if you know a bit of algebra, you will notice that both of these formulas are the same. You just cancel out the A's and this is the formula that you will be getting, right? So this is the second method of calculating the percentage increase or decrease. And what we can do now is just write it in the original format, just using the A and B, and that's going to be this divide by this, and you get the percentage. Now, if I copy it towards the right hand side, I will get the same percentage increase or decrease like we got in the first method. So these are the two methods that you use to calculate percentage increase or decrease within Excel. Now you decide which particular formula is easier for you to type. If you have a particular favorite formula by now, please mention that in the comment section below. Also, if you like this tip and trick, please hit the thumbs up button, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.